Over 2,000 years ago, Hippocrates said, "All disease begins in the gut." I am quite sure he was unaware of the trillions of bacteria that reside there and how they influence health and disease. Today, I'm happy to be here to tell you a little bit about the recent hype that's associated with microbes and mental health. What are microbes? Microbes are bacteria, they're viruses, they're fungi, they're protozoas, they're parasites. And what might be surprising to you is that all of the surfaces of your body are covered with microbes. When we consider microbes and mental health, most of the attention has been placed on the gut bacteria. Fun fact, the weight of your gut bacteria is 3 kilograms. That is the same as the weight of the average adult human brain. And in the last decade, researchers have determined that your gut bacteria actually is critical to brain development, and that microbiota-brain interactions are actually important for brain health. So what do we know about our gut bacteria? There are 100 trillion bacteria in your gastrointestinal tract. There are more microbes than there are eukaryote cells in your body. So you might have heard the term microbiome. The microbiome actually refers to all of the microbes and all their related genetic material. When we consider our commensal bacteria compared to our own DNA, we're completely outnumbered. What we learned from the Human Genome Project is we have 26,000 human genes. Our gut bacteria have over 2 million genes. And so we have this symbiotic relationship with our gut bacteria that starts at birth, pretty much at birth. And it develops over the first year of life. And it's critical to brain development, to behavior. In the past decade, we've learned that individuals with disorders using sequencing tools that allow us to map out the composition that's in our gut bacteria, that there are differences with people with brain disorders. Our DNA, our genetic makeup, is important to the bacteria that's in our gut. And in addition, diet and early lifestyle influences the composition and the diversity of the bacteria in our gut. And it's understanding how these gene-environment interactions are important to brain and microbiota communication that we might actually start to understand the basis of the heterogeneity in brain disorders. And in the past decade, we've actually learned that some individuals with autism have a different profile of bacteria in their gut. And so the next exciting phase of research is in fact our ability to determine how treatments that might target the microbiota can improve the lives of individuals with autism. And the evidence to date is quite hopeful. Thank you.